my channel. My name is Brittany Bundles and welcome to our Sunday Chit Chat Q&A video. If you are new to this channel, on Sundays, I read through questions via comments, DMs, text messages, emails. I choose one topic to go over and elaborate on. So if you are interested, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Please make sure that you are subscribed and let's get right into the video. So today I do want to go over it started off as a comment and then I asked, for the comment to be sent to my email. So I really appreciate you for sending this email to me explaining what happened so that we can kind of talk about it today in this video. And I'm going to be going over some of my tips and points that could help in this situation and just shedding my insight on the matter. So I'm going to start off with the email. So the email is titled Rude Customers and it says, "Hello, how do you deal with rude customers who set out to leave bad reviews because they couldn't carry out a successful refund scam? Here's the backstory. I was selling a product a lady was interested in and she was going to buy it." And it says buy it. So I noticed she entered two different addresses for shipping and billing. Red flag. I kindly told her, "I'm sorry, both addresses have to be the same in order to place an order due to the risk of fraud." She immediately got upset and started accusing me of scamming customers and that she would spread bad reviews about my business if I did not send her the product. I know I read that a little fast, so I apologize, but pretty much, you know, just to kind of sum everything up, she was dealing with a customer and the customer had two different addresses on the order, like I mentioned. Now, if you've watched a lot of my videos, then you know that there are some red flags that can alert you to a potential fraudulent order. A lot of times if people are paying with a credit card, you have to have both of the addresses match. Now, the reason being is because if someone, like in my situation years ago, I don't even know if it was years ago, but a while ago, someone purchased hair for me and the address on their credit card did not match the address that the hair was going to be shipped to. I didn't think it was a big deal because people do that all the time. However, they did go ahead and dispute the charge. And when it came time for me to present the evidence, it didn't look too good on my behalf because I have to prove that the person that ordered it, so whoever's name and address is on the card, I have to prove that they got the product or that they ordered the product. And if the product was shipped to a completely different address and if they're not being honest and saying, hey, you know, this was my product, then it looks as if I sent the product to someone else's address with their information without their consent, especially if that's the story that they're sticking with. So in order to minimize the risk of fraud orders, it's always great to make sure that both addresses match. This is not something that just pertains to the hair industry. A lot of different companies have the same practice. There are some companies that don't, but a lot of companies do. You know, the address has to match. So you want to make sure that you're protecting yourself and your business. And if that's your policy, then I would stick by that. Now, the first thing that I want to kind of go over is I always talk about using secure methods for payments. That's another way that you can definitely cut down on fraudulent orders. I don't take credit cards at this point. There's a lot of companies that don't take credit cards at this point just because there is so much. I mean, there's just a high level of fraud with credit cards and being able to dispute the charges and then you receiving chargebacks, meaning you send out the product and then the customer files a dispute with their bank saying that they didn't order and then the bank doing their investigation. And if that hair went to another address that's not authorized on that card, then a lot of times, you know, they will win the dispute, the claim. So with that being said, you just want to make sure that you're rereading the policies that come along with any payment provider that you're using. So if you're using PayPal, read through their payment and dispute processes. If you're using a credit card company, Shopify payments, read through everything, you know, any payment method that you decide to use, make sure you're reading the fine print. Also, set the right expectations for your customers so that they know upfront that, hey, you know, if the credit card address does not match the shipping address, or if the purchasing address does not match the shipping address, then I cannot, you know, I'm not able to proceed with that, with this order. So make sure that's kind of outlined just so that you can kind of set the tone and the right expectations. Not saying that it wasn't, I'm just saying if it's not, make sure that you do that just so that customers can know before they even place their order that, hey, you know, this is what needs to be done. And also put in your like policies and procedures that place an order and their billing address is different from the shipping address, that order is going to automatically be canceled. Now, I do want to say this, customers or people that are wanting to get over on you, whether it be in your own business or whether it be you're working for another company, just in my experience, they do try to play on the fact of, you know, making you scared, scaring you into sending them the product. But you want to make sure that you remain calm in the situation and that you keep a level head and don't really let them get the upper hand as far as getting you out of your element. Because when you get out of your element, a lot of times you're not really thinking clearly. People will try to threaten to write bad reviews. They'll threaten to badmouth your business. They'll threaten to do a lot of things. But what I want to, you know, really point out is you only can control what you can control. So if someone wants to lie or say something about you, a lot of times people can weed through lies and, you know, it just... their story won't really make sense. But some things that you can do is you can definitely block certain customers from following you on social media, or I don't even want to say customers, certain people from following you on social media, because some people, if you tell them no, they'll even try to harass you on your social media accounts. They'll try to tag you in different things that are just like not true or wrong or just disrespectful. And it's like, I don't have to subject myself to abuse to provide a customer service. That's one thing that you don't have to do. So if someone is getting rude, if someone is being disrespectful, you can kindly save the messages that they are sending, because it sounds like she didn't really purchase anything. So if it's just the fact that you've contacted me and we spoke, you know, you're more than likely to go off and make a review on my customer service. However, if you make a review that's about a product that you never received, you know, there's definitely legal ramifications that you can look into pertaining to your state. And you want to, you know, be careful with this, because especially the people that are wanting to pull scams and things like that, because slander is real. So, you know, what I would do if I was you, if I was the business owner, I would definitely keep track of everything that was said, whether it be via email, text message, just keep track of everything. That way, if something does arise or if someone is trying to slander your business or your name or your product, you can definitely have proof to back up and show, hey, this is not what happened at all. So that's one of the reasons that I also make sure that a lot of my correspondence is through text message and email. A lot of people, you know, regret not having proof and not having documentation regarding a conversation, you know, in their files. In some states, it's illegal to record phone calls. So if you can't use a phone call to back up anything that's happening, it's always great to have as much as you can in writing. So if this happened via email, that's perfect. That's great. If a bad review does surface, you know, then you can definitely go under the review and you can write what actually happened if you want to. Now, you don't have to write it in a messy way where you're arguing with anyone, but you definitely can protect your brand in a respectful and professional way. Now, the next thing that I want to touch on is, like I just mentioned, you can leave a comment kind of providing your evidence and explaining that this review, you know, is not true. There's a lot of people that go on to different companies and leave bad reviews because they're personally mad at the person, or they're just having a bad day, or they just want to. I never would understand why someone would want to negatively tarnish someone else's business. I don't get that. I'm a strong believer in karma, you know, and I just believe that what you put out, a lot of times you get back. So I never want to down talk anyone's business. And I, like I said, I don't understand why anyone else would want to either. However, you do get people that do want to do that because you are in business. But like I said, make sure that you're reading up on the laws in your state. Make sure that you're taking a look at your reviews to see if any of them are slander. And also save the evidence so that you can protect your business and your company if it comes down to it. And then, you know, my next tip is you only can control what you can control. So you really can't control what anyone is going to say about you. You really can't control what anyone is going to do. All you can do is make sure that you're prepared so that if someone does do something that's not right, that's illegal, says something that's false, like I said, you have your evidence or your receipts, like people like to say, to make sure that you are protecting yourself, your business, and, you know, also your customers, so that your customers know, hey, this really didn't happen. And people are understanding, you know, as many people that you get that are going to be difficult to deal with or maybe rude, there's way more people that are going to be understanding and supportive to the situation. Even sometimes when I'm looking at different websites, I'll see, or looking even on social media, I'll see some bad reviews, and then I'll see people commenting under the bad reviews like, hey, you know, if you had this issue, why didn't you contact customer service? Or, hey, you know, this is completely different from the experience that I've had. You know, the owner has always been polite with me. Or, hey, you know, maybe you just received a defective item. If you contact this number, they're really good about making sure they fix the issue. So like I said, there's a lot of people that will be understanding to the situation. Not everyone is just going to jump on the negative bandwagon. But if that, you know, if someone decides to, then I would still make sure, like I said, just be prepared, look into your laws. If it's becoming too disrespectful, if they are continuously being rude, contact you on your social medias and just, you know, tagging you and, you know, just things that you just don't want to be associated with, then you can definitely block different people. You don't have to subject yourself to verbal or, you know, any type of abuse because you are a business owner. You don't have to. There still has to be a line of respect mutually on both sides. And so to wrap this video up, I really just want to say that, you know, you really can't control everyone, but I do know that people that are trying to get over in any industry, they do play on the, you know, they sometimes try to make it seem like they're angry and they try to hold things and say, you know, I'm going to lie on you if you don't do this. I'm going to say this. I'm going to say that. And it's like, you know what, whatever makes you feel good, you do that. Just know that I'm going to keep my receipts. I'm going to keep all the information. If it's something that is going to be a legal matter, then that's how we'll deal with it. If it's not, then okay, whatever. I'll make sure that I keep my receipts or my proof. But you know, this is my policy. It's written here. You know, I'll be more than happy to send you a screenshot of the policy. Sometimes I've even done that. People are like, hey, I didn't see this listed on your website. I'll go ahead. I'll screenshot where I have it listed and send it right back to them. Or I'll pull up the, sometimes like with shipping, people will be like, well, I thought you said I was going to have it here next day. Nope. On shipping, on when you place an order, it shows you the expected duration and the shipping time frame. I have that right here. I'll go ahead and send you a copy. So just make sure that you are prepared. That's why I say in a lot of videos that being organized and making sure that you know your policies and making sure that you have the right expectation to your customers is crucial in my experience, because it just sets the tone for how everything is going to run. Just keep in mind that you are the owner of your business. You're the one that's responsible for protecting your brand. So, you know, the more correspondence that you have, I would definitely consider trying to direct some of those correspondence and communication pathways to email or text. That way, everything is right there. Everything is right there. So that's my take on it. I really hope that everything works out for you. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them down below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.